I'm here to say, oh, Bob's the world. Bob's the world, me say. I'm off to pay a tax in a Bob's the world. You make me tell you something about for them, girl. I'm off to pay a tax in a...
Let's get into this. Wade in the water, children, because this is going to be the slave master edition of Babsy's blog, because it come in like most people out here are slaves, and I really want to address this slave mentality thing. So let me start drilling Wana from early. First thing first, I want to say something. A real tick off with the Calypso entities in Trinidad. Penguin recently died, and if those of you who do not know Penguin, you don't know soca music, keep from around the fucking thing. Everybody thinks they know about music because they know about Fantastic Friday and Super Blue. Yeah, he had songs before then. And why I'm upset that no one's done any form of a tribute to Penguin is because Penguin held weight against Super Blue back in the 80s. I'm sweet in the goat mouth, sour in the bam bam. Actually, I'm going to play an outro song from him because I feel like, you know what? I respect the veterans in my industry. The soca, reggae, calypso, dancehall. Speaking about soca industry, wanna hear that Denise Belfon husband sexually assault a woman, 24 years old, was sexually assaulted. He raped she, what he do? Cause this seem real odd. Denise Belfon have a husband? When she get married? Anyway, somebody come give me that scoop cause everybody tight-lipped about that. Someone come give me the scoop on Lil Wayne too cause everybody tight-lipped about that. He dead? He ain't dead? He writes red? What going on about there? You understand? Now, let me go to Barbados because I didn't cuss a Bajan for a while. And they say I hard on them so I could get even harder because them is fucking nuisances when I'm ready. First thing first, I see this video going around on Facebook. This mother beating she child with a wooden stick plank 2x4. Like when I say stick, like it's like a board. Like, you know what I mean? I'm like, oh. And what I found baffling about it was like, okay, apparently daughter does a Blue movie. And in the Blue movie, she called her mother a pussy hole. Now, seeing your mother beat you in a row really means you probably are a pussy hole. Yeah, Miss Ivy, mom, you're a pussy hole, right? When I say Miss Ivy, let me clarify that. Ivy is the area district that these people are from in Barbados. Before somebody go tell Bounty Killer talking about he mother, because he can come beat me with a hammer. Well, is a certain hammer I would like he hit me with, but let me not get into that. Now, you hear that your child call your names on the people video and you decide you want to beat her in the road. What has me baffled is this fucking assholery Bajans, number one, that stand up there and videotape and watch this whole thing going down. None of you saw the need to go in there and actually pull this mother off her child. What if she snapped her neck by putting her knee in her neck? Then what? Oh, poor thing, she dead and she mother. You all are fucking goats. That is the truth. And I am so tired of some of you. You would report me upon Facebook, but you'd watch a mother beat her child with a 2x4. Oh, she want beating. It's a good Beijing beating. Now, let me tell you something about Beijing beatings. I grew up in a house where licks was actually kind of forbidden. My father has never put his hand on me. My mother has hit me twice. Okay? Now, my brother, let's go into this because I want you to see that licks may not necessarily work and doesn't have to be the method of choice used in parenting. My brother is a year older than me. He's married. He has child within wedlock. He does not have no baby mothers running around the place. He has never been to jail. He has never been arrested. He has his job. He's going to get his 5-year pin from Bell Mobility very shortly. Now, he's never got licks in his life. I actually got them. Now, what I want you to know is this. When you use logic and reasoning with your children, they will understand. You can't go at the people's house. Why? Because I said so as your mother. Does that really make sense? Like, listen to yourself when you talk to people sometimes and tell me that that's going to work. So when your child sees that you're not there, they're still going to go to so-and-so's house. Now, my father, Father Bentley, I love you. Why am I not able to go to so-and-so's house? Carla, the people that molest the children. You want to go there and get molested, go ahead. But I would advise you not to go there so that their big father doesn't push his penis in your small vagina. Oh, thanks, Dad. That makes sense. So what I'm trying to say to you is that beating your children does not mean anything. That's what slave masters did to slaves, and you notice there was still a revolt. That is theoretically what will happen. Beating your child just means that they will act straight in front of you. It does not instill morals, beliefs, anything that is positive in them, but only to not play the fucking idiot in front of you. This is why they will go to school and go and piss on someone's child. This is why they're gonna go and rob somebody, because they don't have morals instilled in them. They just know that when mom is around, I'm not to do these things because she will beat me. Thank you very much. Next assholery movement in Barbados. And before I go off that, what pissed me off about that video is that these bitches is beat the children. And when I just see them in Swan Street and they're like, oh, Babsy, fuck you, da da da, I'm like, yeah, bring it. They run into police talking about Babsy threatening them. Keep from beating your child. Learn logic. And if you don't have any logic, watch me. I'm gonna teach you some. Now, Rastafarian family in Barbados living on people's land. Sagicor apparently bought the land. Apparently, this family claims now the Bagenjin Morgan heritage. They claim that the plantation owner gave them permission to live on the land. Now, were they wading in the water with this plantation owner? We don't know. Is this legit? Are they lying? Are they telling the truth? We don't know. All we know right now is that Sagicor owns the land. They living on it. 5 shanty houses. No electricity. No running water. Sagicor, I'm going to tell you right now, Sagicor, I love you. You have shown me that you are willing to resolve a situation. You went above and above beyond the call of duty to do so. I highly respect y'all. Y'all understand what I'm saying? Offered the family $1 million Bajan dollars, $500,000 US. They offered them 4 acres of land and the title to the land for themselves to come off the land. Now, Rastafari movement doesn't want to come off the land because they say that it is theirs and they're squatting and they're Ray and they're Tay. Now, let me tell you what is the fucking problem. You cannot go up on people's land and build house and claim that is yours. Why you think that people out there robbing and taking up shit from people? Bitches like me that gotta go work hard and then you wanna come rob my car from me. You cannot go up on people's land and claim that you own it. If you don't own it, you don't own it. Mistake number one. Rastafari movement number issue 2. You own nothing. You have 55 children. You're competing with Morgan Heritage. Okay? What you really should do is should have taken the money from Sagicor, give your family some sort of substance and stability for the future, because you got grandchildren running around on people land. And if it was my land, I would have come out there with an AK-47 and blaze up wanna. You understand? Because I deal with vigilante justice. We know this. Furthermore, I would have done call Kyle Williams. Yo, Kyle Williams. Those of you who don't know Kyle Williams actually owns Barbados. There's rumors that Barbados owns Barbados and Trinidad owns Barbados. No. Kyle Williams owns Barbados. He owns all the land. I would have called him and be like, yo, Ross, man, bring a bobcat bulldozer thing about there. Let me lick off these people. They wouldn't even get in the negotiations. The fact that they turned down the money baffles me, because you have nothing to give your future family. Nothing. This is what is wrong with black people. Oh, Rastafari movement and Rastafari. Fuck that. Religion have to get thrown out the window sometimes to have logic and sense. People, take the people, wrestle money, go and voice them and compete with Morgan Heritage and get on with your life. You're going to end up losing this battle and you're going to be stupid about it. I off that. Now, people going to be vexed this week. I got some things to say. Speaking about religion, I want to say something to you motherfucking Christians. Leave me to fuck alone. You want to know why? I real pissed off. You always inboxing me this thing, but don't curse, don't this. Your problem is that you like to judge people too much. Keep from round the people church, because you're just going there to talk about Sister Scantlebury and what she had on last week, but how great thou art. Yeah. Then now you're going to be sitting down watching who's giving what offering, talking about who breck from who ain't breck. Lastly, you're going to be up skinning teeth with the people pastor who married. You still want foot the man, and you know that the man got he eye on more than the sparrow. Leave me to fuck alone. Next one now. Those of you who are sexually confused, let's give you Bajanology 101, because this is logic and reasoning. Let's go from here. Men, any of you that take your penis and push it in anything named Bamzi, Bati, Pooch, Asshole, whatever you want to call it, you are semi-blurring. Because you are one willy bounce away from pushing your penis in a man's ass. Because ass is meant to excrete waste products, anus, rectum, anything so. When you push your penis inside that, you're dirty. I don't care that you do it, but don't come and tell me that I'm wrong because I don't want you to push your doggy in my ass. get the fuck from around me. You are a pervert. And that is why people are all confused about their sexuality. Because you're not supposed to be pushing a penis in an ass. I don't want to hear nothing about no nut busting and the orgasm. Fuck off and keep from around me. Hear me? Good. Next thing, those of you who are going on the pervert line as well, who feel that two women rubbing their pokey on one another is a turn on, you again, one really bounce away from gay. Two women on each other is gay, same way that two men on each other is gay. Do I have a problem with gay people? No, but no gal's not rubbing her pokey on me. Do not come and tell me that that is a turn on. You are gay-ish. Keep that bullshit from round fucking me. I know the difference between reality and your bullshit life. Keep that perversion away. You understand what I'm telling you? If you don't understand that penis plus pokey equals pregnancy, that is what God made man and woman for. Anything else out that is fucking wrong. If you want to be wrong, go be wrong. Don't come and try and coerce me to push penis in my ass and rub pokey on gal. Fuck off. I don't deal with that. You understand what I'm saying? Lastly, those of you who come and tell me, hey, what's up? How you feeling today? Oh, I got a headache. I smoked too much weed last night. You should really get off drugs. No, I smoked marijuana last night. No, marijuana is a drug. No, it's not. Hi, hello. Marijuana is a drug. I have no problem with you being a drug addict. I have a problem when you say that you're not one. And you want me to come and smoke spliff, skliff, blunt, blem, whatever the fuck you want to call it. I do not do drugs. You do. I don't care that you do. Do not tell me that you are right and I am wrong. I don't do drugs. I don't push penis in my ass. I don't rub pokey pon gal. Get what I'm trying to tell you right now. Understand this. If you want to change the world and confuse everybody, that's why Gaza Slim singing about the children are our future. A fucking demon who boss does bleach and fucking do a whole bunch of cunt. That's who telling you children that them got a future. Rascal cunts. Let me do my birthday shout outs peacefully, okay? Because, you know, these people just get serious. Keon Chase, Rainbow Princess, Gary Mayers, Ryan Andrews, Christine Dose, Shawnee Boo, Dane Sadler, Corey Gibson, and Beijing Brina. And as well on my next page, because you know there's a lot of people, I got Beijing Prince Rude Boy, Flair Caribbean, and Patrice Watson. Folks, before I go, I want to say this to you. Please do not write to me. Tell me you looking for love. Who the fuck you just look for love? This is the problem with y'all. Y'all confused. Listen to me and walk straight. You cannot look for love. I don't leave my house saying I'm looking for air. You just look for horn. You don't look for love. You understand what I'm trying to tell you? This is what you need to realize. When it is the right time, it is the right time. When a child is to crawl, it does crawl. When it is to walk, it does walk. You cannot teach the facts of life and the birds and bees to be the birds and the bees. Them that just come so. That's how it is go. Don't question fucking me. You understand what I mean? But what I'm trying to say is, if you want to go in the club with cowboy lashes on and Nicki Minaj pink lipstick when you're black like me, you want push up bubby up here when your breast touch your navel, then you want put on Spanx and suck in your gut, do not be fucking upset when the down low brother is who you end up picking up that bullying people. This is why I want you to know, if you fake, you can pick up fakeness. This is why I would like these bully men to really be who they are and stop trying to come put shit in my fucking crutch.
Keep singing every day, remember, mommy say,
keep singing.